Hey everyone, it's Tyrone from tyroneshum.com. A question I get asked a lot is, how do I train my virtual staff? So today I'm going to be sharing with you a step-by-step process in how to train your virtual staff. So you found your virtual staff and you're ready to move on and you're ready to get them to start working for you and working for you full-time, let's say about. Even if they're not working for you full-time, part-time's fine. Okay, let's start with the first thing. The first thing is to talk a little bit more about exactly what you need to do to be able to prepare them so that they can know exactly what they need to do. And the first point I want to note to you is train them only one thing first. So start them off with one main task. Let's take for example, if you want them to run a whole campaign for say AdWords or say you want them to set up a website for you, that is just one project or one task. And you want to train them up so that they familiarize themselves and get really, really good at this one task. What I usually do is before I get them to start on a project is I actually sit down firstly and I open up my mind mapping software. The software that I use to be able to generate a mind map is called Freemind. And you can download it at Freemind if you just run it on a Google search, on the internet. And it's basically a mind mapping software which allows you to be able to lay out step by step the path and the process or the screen flow on how you go about getting the project done. If you just want to brain dump all your information, that's a great way to do it and use Freemind to do that. Now, if you want more of a structure where you just go step by step showing them a flowchart, let's say for example, there's a really good software that I also use called Gliffy. And you can download it or use it at Gliffy.com. And that allows you to be able to draw arrows and boxes and whatnot to be able to do a nice little flowchart of what you need to be done. So those are the two pieces of software that I usually use. I start off with Freemind first, dump all my information and ideas onto paper or onto the computer, seeing exactly where it's going to head and exactly what I want to do. Then I jump straight into Gliffy and do a screen or a flowchart to say of exactly where the tasks and how the processes work. So once I've done that, then what I'll do is I'll take my flowchart and I'll put together a step-by-step instruction of how to complete a task. And I'll start to generate those videos to go with those. And the way I generate those videos is to either sit in front of the camera like I am doing right now, or to turn on my computer and I have a little webcam and talk in front of the camera and I can do that. Or if it is a very, very technical side of things, I actually turn on my little software called Jing. And Jing Project is a free software made by TechSmith, which you can download from jingproject.com, I think it is. And that basically captures 5 minutes of what you're doing on your screen. And that way you can easily show your virtual staff or your virtual assistant step by step exactly what needs to be done and how to go about approaching it. So that's what I do is create those videos. Once I've created those videos, then I upload it into my project management system. And once that's done, I send it straight over to my virtual staff. And I say, look, start from steps 1 to step 5 and just learn how to do those steps. And once you've done that, start doing my work for me. And that's exactly how I go about training my virtual staff. It's not anything that's really difficult. It just takes a bit of time. But the best thing I can recommend you to do is to take some time out and just set these training videos up. Because once you set them up once, they're there forever. And it will save you amount of ample time. Because once you've trained up your virtual staff, they can train your virtual staff, the new virtual staff that you hire later on by just giving these same videos to them. And they'll be able to add tips, points, etc. to it. And one last thing I want to also mention to you too is make sure you get your virtual staff or your virtual assistant to document everything that they do. So if they've implemented a new process or added some new tips or ideas on how to make this process better, get them to document it for you and upload it into your project management system. So that way they can always refer back to it. And that's pretty much on how you go about doing that. So hopefully that little tip can help you save a man of time in training your virtual staff, because that's something that I find has been quite a turning point for a lot of people, because I find that that's what holds them back is from taking that next step to be able to free themselves up to do the things that they need to do. But because they haven't trained their virtual staff, they're still running back and forth trying to get them to do the same things over and over again. Okay. So that's pretty much what I do. And I'd love to hear some of your feedback and your comments. Just put them right below at my blog. And if you're watching this on YouTube, just visit my blog at tyronshum.com. So I'll see you in the next video. It's Tyrone Shum from tyronshum.com, and look forward to seeing you soon. Bye for now.